The document checklist that you need for your F1 visa. This video will give you this checklist, which will get you sorted as far as the documents are concerned. So keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and I'm a travel and a visa coach. On this channel, you will find tons of useful videos on the US visa process. So make sure to check them out. We are in the F1 visa series and this is the fourth video in this series. We already have three videos, so if you haven't watched those videos, check them out. I'm sure it's going to help you. Today's video is all about the document checklist. So a lot of you have messaged me asking for a document checklist. So in this video, we are going to do exactly that. We will break down this humongous checklist into three different categories, which will make it easier for you to, you know, fetch these documents, organize them, and keep it ready. Now, do keep in mind that the exact checklist will vary for each person. It will depend upon their profile and background. But in this video, we will discuss the most important and the most commonly asked documents. If you want a personalized document checklist and a more in-depth interview preparation, you can book a one-to-one consultation session with me. The link for that is in the description box below. So let's get started and we will start with the first category. The first category is the essential document. Now these are the documents which remain pretty much the same for everybody, no matter their profile, no matter their background. And these are the documents which you need. These are must-haves for you to be able to go and give your F1 visa interview. So under the essential documents, we have your passport. So your old passports as well as the current one, you need to carry all of them. Your I-20, the most important one for an F1 visa. Your service fee receipt, showing that you've paid the service fees. Your DS-160 confirmation page, the confirmation page, which, you know, gives you your application ID. It also says which center, which date and time you have your visa appointment. So this is your essential document checklist. The next category of documents that we have are the financials. Now, the financials are perhaps the most important documents in your entire F1 visa checklist. And these are the documents which essentially show that you have enough funds to go and, you know, complete your education in the US. In fact, we have an entire video on the financials of F1 visa, how to prepare your documents, how to prepare your funding and everything. So this was the last video on the F1 visa series. So if you want to check out that video, I'm sure it's going to help you. So coming to the document checklist, under financials, what all do we have? First one is a bank sanction letter. So if you're going to take a loan and you're funding your education through a loan, a bank sanction letter which clearly states, you know, the terms and conditions, which clearly states the amount, the collateral, all these things are going to be important. The second one, an affidavit of support from your sponsor. So if somebody else is sponsoring your education, let's say that your father is funding you, then an affidavit of support from him stating that, you know, he is funding you, he is supporting you, is going to be important. The third one, bank statement of last 6 months. So the bank statement of your sponsor for the last 6 months is going to be required. If you are funding your education yourself, then you can take your own bank statement. ITR return of last 3 years. Again, this has to be of the sponsor. If it's you, then yours, else whoever is sponsoring you. Pay slips of last 3 months. So the pay slips of your sponsor for last 3 months, that is essential. Next one is proof of funds. So this is basically the funds that you're going to show for your education. So be it FD, be it cash and bank balance, be it mutual fund, however you're funding your education, a proof of funds showing that these funds are available and they are in your bank is going to be important. And the last one is proof of other investments. So any other investments that you might have, such as bonds, property, long-term assets, proof of these investments, either a CA statement or a statement from the bank, is also going to be important. Now, do keep in mind that these other investments are not liquid, so you cannot use it to directly show as a means to funding your education, but they can be used to show that you have some backup options, some buffer options. In the description box below, we have a free PDF. This PDF is the document checklist that we are discussing in this video. So once you're done watching this video, make sure that you click on that link and download your free PDF copy. This will be handy for you, you know, whenever you're preparing your documents, it'll make this entire process really simple. The third category of documents that we have are all the documents related to your academic and your work profile. So starting with the academics, you need to carry your transcripts, your degree certificate. If your degree certificate hasn't come in yet, a provisional degree certificate will do. If you do not even have the provisional degree certificate, then an email or a letter from the admin of your college saying that you're in the final year and you know you have either given your exams or you're due to appear for your final exams will also do. Then test scores. So test scores such as GRE, TOEFL, if you have taken these scores and your university, you know, has asked for these scores, then you need a proof of these test scores. From the last 1 year, a lot of colleges have done away with GRE, TOEFL scores. They have waived it off because of, you know, the coronavirus pandemic. So if that is the case, then you can skip this. But if your university has asked for GRE or TOEFL, then make sure that you carry these test scores with you for the interview. Next, we have proof of any other courses, any online or offline courses that you might have done. So many times when students present their profile, they talk about the extra things they would have done, you know, extra internships, courses, online classes and so on. So if you have done any of these and this is going to be part of any of your answers in the visa interview, then make sure that you carry proof of these as well. Then comes a resume. So this is especially important if you're working. Make sure that you have a resume with you and also make sure that the resume is updated, you know, with all your current work experience. And one more thing that you can do is also update your LinkedIn profile. So in the DS-160 form, you would have seen that there's a section to give all the social media identifiers. So if you're working, you can definitely put your LinkedIn profile and make sure that your resume as well as your LinkedIn profile are both updated. Then we have admits from other universities. So if you've got admits from other universities, carry proof of that. Many times in the visa interviews, students are asked whether they've got admits from other universities. So it is best to just carry proof for that. Scholarship letter. So if you have received a scholarship letter from the university where you're going to be joining, then do carry that scholarship letter because this is something that you should mention in your answer when you're asked about why this university or why this college. Getting a scholarship is one of the main reasons, or rather it's an important reason for joining a university or a college. And if you plan to mention it in your answer to the visa officer, then it's best to carry proof of that. And lastly, a work experience letter. So if you are working, then a letter from your company HR, which basically states the number of years of your work ex, your designation, your main role or your area of expertise is required. So this was our document checklist. So we have three categories, the essentials, the financials and the work academic documents. Like I mentioned earlier, in the description box below, you will find a link for a free PDF. And this PDF is this entire document checklist in one place. So download it, keep it handy and use it when you prepare your documents. If you have any more questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. You can also DM me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is at shachi.mal. And like I said, if for a more in-depth personalized preparation, you can book a consultation session with me. You can also book a mock interview. This mock interview will be done on a video call. It'll be very similar to the actual visa interview and will help you get ready for the process. We also have an interview prep course, and this course will help you to structure and prepare your answers. There are templates and sample answers which are included as part of this course. So go ahead and give that a look as well. All these links are in the description box. Before I end, here's an update about the F1 visa status in India. I know that a lot of you are right now stressed and, you know, just confused because either your visa appointments have got cancelled or you're not able to book an appointment and, you know, get a slot. And I'm here to tell you that do not panic, stay calm. This is happening to everybody. This is because of the coronavirus situation in India. Embassies are either working at very limited capacity or they have shut for the next couple of weeks. So in the meanwhile, this is what you can do. A, like I said, stay calm, stay patient. This issue will get resolved soon. Second, keep checking for slots and availability every single day. Check at least twice a day, preferably early morning and late at night, because these are the times the slots generally get released and we don't know when they're going to release it. So just be proactive. Third, keep your location flexible. Do not fixate on any particular city or embassy. Keep it flexible. Be ready to travel anywhere in India for your F1 visa interview. And last but not the least, stay prepared. Make sure that your DS-160 is filled and ready. Make sure that you're thoroughly prepared for the interview. Do not, you know, give up on the preparation right now, because as soon as a slot is available, you want to be able to just go book, give your interview and smash it. So make sure that you stay ready and prepared. Of course, any new updates, anything else, we will bring it on this channel right here. So stay tuned here, stay subscribed, and I'll try my best to bring all the updates to you. That's all for this video. Signing off for now. Stay safe. And in the next week, we are going to talk about, this will probably be the last video in the F1 visa series. And in this video, we'll talk about all the insider tips and tricks to cracking your F1 visa interview. So don't miss that video. Signing off for now. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.